with some water and some flow improver, which helps to make the paint more stable. I'm going to wet the sky. I wet the paper a little bit more before I go down. Brush off my brush because otherwise you get too strong with blue. And go about a third of the way down the paper. And just let it run a little because that makes some lovely cloud shapes. A bit more across the top there. More. It's a good rule to follow. It's the rule of thirds. I made some little lines there, roughly a third of the way down the paper. So this would be the sky, and that's where I'll start the sea and the land. Now then, for the sea, and now just a tiny bit of white. I'm trying to make a straight line across. Some land in just now, but that's roughly where this horizon is. So now wet the paper a little bit more so that the paint will run in some nice wave shapes. There's a nice thing about acrylics. You can use them thin in a watercolory sort of a style, or you can use them thicker and have bright colours. Just depending on what you're trying to achieve. Now I've got a little cerulean blue that I'm adding now because the sea needs to be a slightly different colour, especially in the foreground. And if I leave just a tiny gap here and there, it should look like waves, hopefully. Tiny little gap there and there. Right, rinse my brush off well. Now then I'm going to have buff titanium for some beach. And I'm just going to miss the blue because I don't want it to mix. Added a little flow improver to my water. It's the best thing to do with it, and that makes sure that your paint will flow nicely. But if you use just water, the colours can change after a while. Just as for an experiment, you're perhaps not too bothered if they do, but if you want your painting to last, and if it does sometime you want to sell it, it's far better to use the flow improver. Helps to keep the colours as they last for years and years. Now that's just a simple beach. A little bit more colour maybe in the foreground. Incidentally, the brush I'm using is a filbert brush. They're nice because you can use them flat or you can use the point. There's all sorts of different shapes. Now I think that line near the sea is fairly dry, so I'll just go a little bit closer. Acrylics do dry pretty quickly, so if you want to just get on with it, that's a good point. Now between the sea and the beach, I'm going to put a very slight grey line, which I hope won't run because that's also a bit wet. If you look at the sea when it's lapping on the beach, tend to see a little darker area just at the edge of the sea. There's a little bit of a white wave somewhere. I'm using the brush like that on the edge so that I just get a thin line. Outside, I don't know if you can hear that. Right, now then, I hope that it's dry enough that I can put in a distant piece of land with a little bit of Payne's grey and another little bit of blue. And just on the horizon, but a rocky distant cliff. And maybe you might want a little bit of a rock showing just here. The great thing about acrylic as well is you can go over anything if you don't like something you've done, especially if you haven't got much texture. You can just paint over it. Sometimes you might need to go over it with white to blank out the mistakes you've made and then put the next layer on top. So with a bit thicker paint now, and I'll come down so that it makes little rock shapes. Wash my brush again. Dry it off a little bit on the side of the pot. And hear my cat scratching. Just a few waves in, lapping on the rocks. And there we have just a very simple seascape. I like particularly how the waters run and bled down